the general topic of Vision 2020, after which we have one more speaker. So, Mr. Locke, thank you for being with us tonight.
Great, thank you. I wanted to speak to something that Ms. Wollner actually spoke about just a few minutes ago. I'm here because I want to see some innovative strategies incorporated into Vision 2020 five-year plan that you will be rolling out soon. And I want to strongly promote an idea that is developing steam, one that has been initiated by students currently in the JCPS schools, and that is for there to be a complete overhaul in how history is taught so that comprehensive Black history is integrated into all U.S. history classes. So that it more accurately reflects how we view our common past. Advocates for this are using the phrase Black History Matters, and my thoughts are rooted in the belief that students will dedicate themselves to their studies more readily, and we will see scores improved if their studies better connect with their real lives as they learn their true history. You know, right now, if you talk to any students, they'll say, well, we learned about Harriet Tubman and Rosa Parks and Martin Luther King. But what's missing from current history curriculum are the rich contributions of Black Americans in all spheres of our national life, from science to culture to education and medicine. The ways in which racism has impacted all of our common concerns, such as housing, employment, healthcare, and education. The movements that resisted white supremacy, not just in the 50s and 60s, but for over 400 years through the present day. And the ways in which white, Black, and brown people worked together to create progress during that same period. There is little, if any, discussion of how Black people in this country are part of a colorful tapestry worldwide known as the African diaspora, in which people of African descent positively transformed every society in which the slave ships dropped off their human cargo. This is unacceptable, and it must change. It's important to the Black students who will perhaps for the first time better understand their roots and identities, so that each student will be able to say, in the words of Emerson, I contain multitudes. They will be able to see their aspirations reflected throughout history in ways that open up possibilities for the future instead of segregating their dreams down dead-end roads. But Black students are not the only ones who will benefit, because as things stand now, white students are seeing an incomplete picture of their own history as well, which affects attitudes and behaviors towards all people of color in this country. If those young people who are students today are not presented with a complete picture of our common history, of where we have been both together and separately, there is no way we can expect them to tackle the myriad of problems our communities will face in the future. We must know where we've been before we can figure out where we are going. And I think this view is consistent with the JCPS mission statement. Again, the bottom line for me is my belief that students will dedicate themselves to their studies more readily, and we will see scores improve if their studies better connect with real lives as they learn their true history. And I'm encouraging you, as part of the Vision 2020, to incorporate this comprehensive reworking of our U.S. history curriculum. This is an important way to narrow the gap and improve the learning experience for all students.
Okay, thank you for your remarks, and thank you for being with us tonight.